instead of reading a book, which I mentioned last video, it's more important to practice. It's more important to practice. So as we're lounging by the pool, practice. Get used to looking at being aware of what your mind is throwing up to you, and turn that into a practice. So don't let the daydreaming just continue on. Okay, you see, I'm daydreaming this. Let me turn this into a practice. Easier than expected. Wow. Now, last video, we went easier than expected practice, and all positives. Now, today, I worked on all negatives, like more than expected, or stronger than expected. I'm less prepared than expected. Wow. Less prepared than expected now. More confusion than expected. Wow. More confusion than expected. Wow. More disorientation than expected. Wow. So what we're doing here now is we are being pragmatic in that for sure there will be this shock arising when we have a frame of reference shift that will be more than expected. Now, it'll be more on the positive side, but also on the trepidation side, we'll say, you know, it's more freak out than expected. More disturbance than expected. More shock than expected. Wow. More surprise than expected. Wow. More vastness than expected. Wow. And so when we get our expectations to expect this, we've done pretty much the best we can do, right? So when it's more than expected, we say, well, I expected more than I expected. Absolutely. I expect more than I expect. More overwhelming than expected. More overwhelming than expected. Okay, so this is the flip side of the positive. Before we say, oh, more beauty than expected. More beautiful than expected. Wow. More beautiful than expected. Wow. More peaceful than expected. Wow. Easier than expected. Wow. Sooner than expected. Wow. More sublime than expected. Wow. More perfect than expected. Wow. And now we can say more drastic than expected. Wow. More drastic than expected. Wow. More shocking than expected. Wow. More shocking than expected. Wow. We can even say more alarming than expected. More alarming than expected. Wow. So we're covering both the elation and the trepidation of continuity fear, and expecting more in both ways. So our expectations are getting very, very well rooted. We're rooted in this new expectancy, the new way. The new way, new expectancy, okay? Now, to be rooted in this practice is really the most fortunate of circumstances. Here in this world at this point. whatever is taking place in our mind, we can look at it and say, okay, I'm going to put it into this very simple form of practice. As far as a reference, frame of reference shift. So, more difference than I expected. Wow. More wow than I expected. Wow. More amazement than expected. Wow. More difference than I expected. Wow. More shift than I expected. Wow. More shift than I expected. Wow. More shift than I expected. Wow. Wow. So I started practicing this early this morning and practiced all day. So I've been going at it for 12 hours or so today. And without any problem, and still working on it. So we have the positive, more of this, or better than expected. More freak out than expected. More freak out than expected. Wow. More freak out than expected. Wow. More freak out than expected. Wow. So when that feeling arises, we say, well, I expected that feeling. I'm more freak out than expected. Maybe more intensity than I expected. More intensity than I expected. More change than I expected. More change than I expected. More encompassing than I expected. Wow. More encompassing than I expected. So what we're working on is to this new way practice. It seems, I continue to get these very strong indications. It's super important to be rooted in a practice right now. Super, super important. Like a plant rooted in the ground with a source of water and light. Okay. As opposed to a tumbleweed or something that is not rooted. You know, it's a big difference. We want to be rooted in a practice right now as refuge from the storm. So you might say more protection than I expected. There you go. More protection than I expected. That's a real, more safety than expected. Wow. More protection than expected. More safety than expected. Oh, that's a great one. I hadn't thought of that until just now. More safety than expected. Wow. That is marvelous. More marvelous than expected. More marvelous than expected. More protection than expected. More safety than expected. Wow. Fabulous. Wow, wow, wow. More safety than expected. How about that for a great, great practice before the deluge, which is coming very soon? That dream I had where the storm was approaching us, and then it finally hit us, and the deluge. The indications are that it's coming very soon. However, here we are, rooted in a practice already. So this shows that we've been in a race against time. I've always been in this race against time. I knew I had to get to a certain point before a certain time. And this is it. So more safety than expected. Wow. More support than expected. More support than expected. Wow. So now we're back to the positives. More support than expected. Wow. And more safety than expected. Wow. More protection than expected. More peace than expected. More opportunity than expected. More opportunity than expected. More bliss than expected. More bliss than expected. More friendship than expected. More friendship than expected. More communication than expected. More bliss than expected. Talked to a friend today, and he's talking about how he's not worried. It's come what may. He says, well, you know, if it happens, it happens. I'm not going to worry about it. Oh, so well. And he's keeping his mind is trying to, you know, relax. Or many people, many things happened today. Situations that, again, people out of the blue telling me about how the people they deal with in a business, their businesses, are just blowing up. Blowing up. I had another one tell me today. He said, oh my gosh, this guy came in and he just absolutely blew up. And he said they've got to learn to leave their troubles at home. Leave them somewhere else. Don't bring them to work. Don't bring them to work. Don't bring them into us. So two people at the same place talked about how relationships seem to be just blowing up right now. It's unprecedented. We're in this time of tremendous intensity and turmoil, and it's showing up in the house and relationships, and people are then carrying that into their how they relate to others in the world, carrying it with them and displacing it onto others, the problems that they may have at home. So then people are talking about this now. Say, this is very unusual. I said, well, it's the summer of 17. The summer of turmoil, as opposed to 67, the summer of love, but actually that was a summer of turmoil also. So 217, the summer of turmoil. Didn't World War One start in like there was a 218, or was it 14, maybe 14 to 18, 14 to 18. Maybe ended in 18, I don't know. But we're scheduled for another world war, that is for sure. But people get through it, and how? Well, in the past, people were rooted in traditional religions. This time around, they're not so rooted. They're not. They've been uprooted by design. You see, the fact that so many people were so rooted in the past, in their religious practices of prayer and faith and forgiveness and all this, it actually stifled the intensity of the wars. It actually stifled it to a large extent. So the ego didn't get enough bang for its buck. So it said, wow, you know, next time, this has been preparing for this for a long time, the ego, is, you know, we're gonna have as many people as possible uprooted from all of that, and that they feel wrong or guilty or stupid or unethical or just guilty about turning to prayer and faith and all of that. They won't do it. They won't do it. And so the world's been conditioned to not do that, which will lead to them turning to pharmaceuticals, for sure. That's what's happening. Even my friend, a Christian friend, who prays all the time, he still had to turn to pharmaceuticals to calm himself down. So the ego keeps on conditioning, so it gets maximum bang for its buck. Maximum attempt to shock the mind into remembering remembering the power of fixation. Or to somehow create the power of fixation in the mind. It's like, look, mind, look at everything. It's all falling apart. It's all dying. You have to find a way to fixate everything. And the mind's all frantic. So, oh my gosh, I'm panicking. Look what's happening. Panic could be a way of mind trying to pressure mind into coming up with a new power, the power of fixating the mind, instead of, being free, which the mind was created this way. The ego just has all sorts of different ways it's trying to stabilize the mind, fixate the mind. But to be rooted in spiritual practice is the best remedy that most of us have, to say no matter what, we can turn to the practice that we're doing now, the New Way practice. We say, more intense than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, wow. More intense than expected, wow. More intense than, frame of reference shift, wow. More shocking than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift. Wow. More shocking than expected. Wow. Or more devastating. Wow. Frame of reference shift. Wow. More devastating than expected. Not in a destructive way, but devastating can mean something that's just so... it seems to just have, changed everything. It just devastated the old viewpoint. It's gone, more devastating. But we don't use absolutes, okay? We don't say, oh, the old frame of reference is completely gone. So the new way of practicing is we stay away from those types of absolutes, and because our expectations cannot handle absolutes. So in order to recondition or reshape our expectations, we can say more devastating. Well, wow, more devastating than I expected. Wow, more devastating than expected. Frame of reference shift, wow. More devastating than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, wow. More freak out than expected. In other words, my mind is freaking out more than I expected. But we condition ourselves to expect that. Wow, frame of reference shift, wow. More unexpected. Than I expected. It was more unexpected than I expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift. Wow. More unexpected than I expected. How about that? That's a beautiful one. Frame of reference shift. Wow. More unexpected than I expected. Wow. So I love doing these practices. This is the most fun there is for me. I mean, I look forward to every day of, oh my gosh, how fun is it going to be to be able to flip the script like this? It's just the best. We were talking with different people today. It was about how all these vacations, all these things that wealthy people do when they're doing this. And I said, I don't even want to think about it because I can't do any of that. So my recreation and enjoyment has to come from the mind and how I use it, which is free. So I can sit here and do these practices, and that's how I get my fun and recreation is wonderful. But it's free. Frame of reference shift, wow. More total than expected. Frame of reference shift, wow. More total than expected, wow. more frame of reference shift than I expected. Wow. More frame of reference shift than I expected. More shift than I expected. Wow. So this is being super pragmatic. What we are here is super pragmatists. We're not spiritual idealists at all. We've gone way past that now. We're at the point where we're super pragmatists. And we're willing to do what actually works. Forget about the ideology of what we think is supposed to work. Right? Forget about that. We have to do what actually works now. And we spend so much time with our hopes and ideals and spiritual beliefs. This should work. This should work. This should. I want this to work. Instead of doing what actually works. So we don't have any time for what doesn't work anymore. We have to do very directly what does work. Frame of reference shift. Wow. More startling than I expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift. Wow. More startling than I expected. Wow. Awakening. Wow. More shocking than I expected. Wow. More awakening than I expected. Wow. More recognition than I expected. Wow. More recognition than I expected. Wow. Wow. Safer than expected. Wow. So, I feel so intrigued. Frame of reference shift, more intriguing than expected. There you go. So I had this discursive thought, and I suddenly flipped it right away into a practice. I was going to say, I feel so intrigued about this practicing, and I just immediately caught it. I said, hey, frame of reference shift, wow. More intriguing than expected, wow. More intriguing than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, more harmless than expected, more harmless than expected, wow. So we're sort of doing both the positive and negative now that we introduced the negative, and you can use the negative like, frame of reference shift, more decisive than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, more startling than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, more settling than expected, wow. More calm than expected, wow. More safety than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift. More confidence than expected. Wow. We can say, wow, more salvation than expected. Wow, more salvation than expected. More salvation than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift. More salvation than expected. Quieter than expected. Wow. Quieter than expected. Calmer than expected. Calmer than expected. Wow. And safer than expected. Frame of reference shift. Wow. Safer than expected. More enjoyable than expected. Wow. More enjoyable than expected. See, when problems break out in the world, we don't have to say, oh, I don't have enlightenment, oh, woe is me. We say, well, no, I have this practice that will help blend me into enlightenment, so to speak. Remove the obstacles, which is our expectations. Reshape our expectations, what we're doing. And so just keep doing that. You'll be fine. Well, what if you don't have that, you know? All bets are off, that is for sure. We're not relying here on social media to be the answer for us, okay? Not at all. In fact, absolutely explicitly not. It's our ability and willingness to actually practice. And when we know we can do this, we'll say, wow, frame of reference shift, obvious wow. More peace than expected, wow. More peace than expected, wow. And again, we don't try to aggrandize the situation. We don't say incredibly great, vast amounts of more peace than expected. That adds fuel to the fire. So we just stoically say, frame of reference shift, obvious wow, more peace than expected, wow. More forgiveness than expected. Ah, frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. More forgiveness than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. More forgiveness than expected, wow. So nobody wants to be a shopper when troubles break out. You want to feel you got your cave set up fine, just fine. Our cave is a mental cave. We have the cave of practice. We go, I'm going to go to my cave of practice. And we can do that on the fly anywhere. And we were starting to get down and depressed and such, we say, we can say, frame of reference shift, obvious, wow, more disorientation than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow, more disorientation than expected, wow. Now, people will say, well, you're not doing everything you can do. And when people panic, they think, oh, I need to be doing more. I need to be more. I'm not doing everything I can do to help out. And they try everything. But we say, well, we're doing enough. We're doing enough. This practice is all we need to do, actually. And the fact that they're doing too much is based on the fact they're not practicing. There's two types of people in the world, those who practice and those who don't. Very simple. Those who practice are called dharmic. Those who don't practice, say, non-dharmic. Secular world. They do all sorts of stuff. except one thing in common: they don't practice spiritually. They do not. So there's a vast difference between those who do practice and those who don't. It's interesting. Several people, someone asked me today, he suddenly asked me, how do you deal with the stress in your mind and being calm? How do you calm everything down? Because we were talking about how everyone's so agitated now, and those working with the public, serving them, are finding these people are just absolutely flipping out. And I said, how do you stay calm? And I said, well, I give it all to God. Give it to God. And he said, well, what about the money? What about the money? I said, give that to God too. Because he said, okay, but you know, the money, you know, how do we get money? I said, give that to God too. Now we could say, what? We could say, frame of reference of obvious, wow, more prosperity than expected. Frame of reference, wow, more prosperity than expected. See, the ego's told us there's an abyss there. So our expectations are going to certainly be very shocked in many different ways, right? It's going to surpass our expectations in every which way. So we're just preparing for that. Frame of reference shift. Wow, more prosperity than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift. Wow, more abundance than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift. Wow, more abundance than expected. Wow. See, we have faith that we will just simply experience all this. And we could use the feeling thing, like frame of reference shift, wow, obvious wow, feeling more peace than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow, feeling more peace than expected, wow. Okay? I'm chugging away on my 6-to-6 diet. So I said, oh boy, I gotta wait till tomorrow to eat anything. It's just about 6:30 now. So I am making my weight. I'm under my weight, so I got to hold on to that. I have just got to hold on to that. Very important. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. Feeling more disciplined than expected. Wow. Feeling more focused than expected. Wow. Feeling more inner directed than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift. Obvious. Wow. Feeling more inner direct. Inner direction than wow. Innerly directed. Wow. Feeling more inner direction than wow. Feeling more inner direction, wow. Feeling more guided, wow. Feeling more guided than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, wow. Feeling more guidance than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, wow. Feeling more guidance than expected, wow. So people might wonder, well, how are you doing right now? Well, I mean, financially, I'm not doing. In every which way, I'm not doing except practicing. But practicing is the one thing that we're supposed to be doing right now. This is the best preparation for what is to come in this world, is this new way practice. It is the best preparation. Otherwise, I'd be doing something else. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. Feeling more guidance than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. Feeling more grace than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. Feeling more certainty than expected, wow. And frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. Feeling more protected than expected, wow. More protected than expected, wow. feeling more protected than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious. Wow. Feeling more comfortable than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious. Wow. Feeling more at ease than expected. Wow. Feeling more at ease than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious. Wow. Feeling more at ease than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious. Wow. Feeling more at home than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious. Wow. Feeling more at home than expected. Wow. You look at the world right now, and you have to think, you know, the world wants a war. The decisions that people are making, the way things are going, it's like they're intentionally pushing it in that direction. Amazing. Frame of reference shift, obvious. Wow. Feeling more amazed than expected. Wow. Feeling more amazed than expected. Wow. So you see how we can start thinking along a certain line and suddenly just catch it. Just catch it and then say, oh, amazing, I can use that as a practice. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more amazed than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more confident than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more well-being than expected, wow. Feeling more flawless than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. Feeling more flawless than expected, wow. So we can actually practice this way. Those who don't know about this and have not prepared, they won't know how to practice this way. So what do they do? What are they going to do? Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. Feeling more guided than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. Feeling closer to divinity than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obviously, wow. Feeling more normal than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. Feeling more normal than expected, wow. Now, I may have hurt my back swinging the golf club on purpose so that I would not go golfing at this over the last week, because I was planning to really get into it, and it stopped it right in its tracks. So I've been able to work on developing this new way practice that we're doing right now instead of that. And that's a great trade-off, isn't it? Maybe the best back pain, best use of back pain ever. I'll get back to it at some point. The back will get better. And I'll start feeling better. I've been really feeling very down, kind of physically. Sluggish and heavy and just like, oh my gosh, what's going on? But, it gives us a good excuse to just to sit here, right? Yeah. And we can say frame of reference shift. Wow. Feeling more uncertain than expected. Wow. That would be on the negative side. For instance, if we feel totally certain, our expectations will feel like uncertain that that's right or didn't expect it. So the uncertainty will also rise. So we could cover both of them. We say frame of reference shift. Obvious wow, feeling more certain than expected wow. And we can say frame of reference shift wow, feeling, did I say uncertain before? Feeling more uncertain than expected wow. So cover both sides like that. Cover both sides. Because it's true, when we feel like way more certain, we feel more certain than expected. That's also going to bring up this feeling of uncertainty. So I'm not sure what to expect. I'm kind of uncertain what to expect, right? Yeah. So we cover that in our practicing. We might say frame of reference shift, wow, feeling more confident than expected, wow. And frame of reference shift, obvious, wow, feeling more hesitant than expected, wow. We're so confident that we become hesitant. Because our expectations, it's so outside the realm of our expectations, we might say, wait, I'm feeling really hesitant, even though I feel, super really confident. So expect both of those to arise. See? Frame of reference shift, obvious wow, feeling more confident than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow, feeling more hesitant than expected, wow. And we can even use the bliss frame of reference shift. Obvious wow, feeling more bliss than expected. Wow, frame of reference shift. Obvious wow, feeling more despair than expected. Wow. Because exceeding our expectations, we don't know exactly what to do. We think, oh. And so it gives rise to a lot of, trepidation, negative sort of thing, hesitancy, uncertainty, despair, all that stuff is can be the come out of our expectations being so shocked by a frame of reference shift. Frame of reference shift, wow, obvious wow, feeling more delight than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow, feeling more clarity than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious reference shift. Obvious frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more inclusivity than expected, wow. Feeling more inclusivity than expected, wow. Feeling more inclusivity than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more inclusivity than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more allness than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift. Obvious wow. Feeling more totality than expected. Wow. Feeling more totality than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more perceptive than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more perceptive than expected. Wow. Feeling more perspective than expected. Wow. Feeling more perspective than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more essence than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more presence than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more holiness than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more sacredness than expected. Wow. Feeling more sacredness than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more coherent than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more coherent than expected. Wow. Now, this is one we could flip, right? They could cover the other side of, say, frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more incoherent than expected. Wow. Because it will seem to go both ways there. As we feel more coherent than expected, there'll be this sort of shock that to reaction to that, which will seem like some amount of more incoherency than expected. You know, we're expected to be just all perfect coherency, but there's actually going to be some incoherency as a reaction, and so that's more than expected. So we say frame of reference shift, obvious wow, feeling more coherent than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow, feeling more incoherent than expected. Wow. So we are really hitting it hard, aren't we? And I'm driven, because I know from so many warnings I've gotten that we had better be properly prepared. And we are. We're working on it. We're doing what we need to do. Frame of reference shift. Obvious wow. Feeling more prepared than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling less prepared than expected. Wow. There'll be this aftershock of, right? Aftershock that can be negative and saying, wow, this is so much better. This is better than expected, and this is causing me to feel that yeah, there's more trepidation than I expected. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow, more quiet, feeling more mentally composed, feeling more composed than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow, feeling less composed than expected. Wow. Cover both bases. frame of reference, if obvious, wow. Feeling more composed than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift obvious, wow. Feeling less composed than expected, wow. So how are we doing here? We're cruising, oh my gosh, we've been cruising here almost an hour of very intense practicing here. Really fun. What time is it? Okay. Tremendous fun, isn't it? Really, it's for me, there's nothing more enjoyable than this practicing. So that's why I stick with it. One can feel that it's so auspicious. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more auspicious than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow, feeling more auspicious than expected, wow. So it already feels very auspicious. And the other stuff doesn't feel auspicious at all. I'm going around through the world, all the old stuff that I used to try, and I know everyone is still trying, I say, that doesn't seem auspicious at all. It seems inauspicious, actually. Special relationship feels very inauspicious. Everyone will be demanding calm from one another, and they don't know how to help or give it. They don't know. They won't know. So how auspicious is that? Putting your faith in a straw house, you know, built on sand, that's not very auspicious. Build your house upon a rock. The rock of new way practice. Just trying to get through the week here, one week at a time. Most people I speak with realize that something is really, really brewing. I mean, if they looked out to sea, they would see this storm like I saw in the dream, and the lightning, and they'd say, oh. Very charged, extremely highly charged situation. And this is what's showing up out in public is the situation in a lot of people's minds is so highly charged that they're not able to function in a normal civil manner. It's amazing. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more tranquil than expected, wow. And the corollary to that, a frame of reference shift, obvious wow. Feeling more disturbed than expected, wow. The tranquility that we that's more than expected produces a bit of a backlash in our expectations, so we need to cover the feeling more disturbed than expected. If we expect no disturbance at all from our expectations, that will throw us to the ground then, right? It will throw our attention off. But if we expect it, we just say, oh yeah, okay, more disturbance than expected, wow. Our attention just remains steady because we expected it. No reason to pivot off of it. We expected this. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow, more feeling more benevolence than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. Feeling more helpful than expected, wow. Now, in the new way practice, start out by saying, I can do nothing. I can't help anyone in any way. Wow. I cannot help anyone in any way. Wow. I've never been able to help anyone, and I'll never be able to help anyone in any context. I'm incapable of helping anyone. This is devaluing the I. And the more we do this, the more we allow the frame of reference shift to be our salvation, not the I. What the I can do. What the belief in abnormality can do, which is the I, the belief in abnormality. The belief that we can become abnormal. That we can, you know, belief in abnormality. What can that do? It can't do anything for us. It can't help anyone. But frame of reference shift, obvious, wow. Feeling more helpful than expected, wow. So this time right now, we can expect it to be very intense in terms of how we feel. I don't feel on top of the world at all. Very tired, not getting good sleep, keep getting interrupted sleep, all sorts of things. But that's expected. We're not. This is, you know, the lead up to. You know, it's preparation. It's the high preparation, great preparation for whatever there is to, whatever takes place in this world. And whatever our sidestepping turns out to be. Frame of reference shift. Obvious wow. I feel more helpfulness than expected. Wow. So we can say, I feel more helpful, but we can also say, I feel more helpfulness than expected. Wow, it's more helpful to, you know, it's feeling more helpful that I'm getting really, wow, so much help. It's more than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow, feeling more poise than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow, feeling more release than expected, wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious, wow, feeling more openness than expected, wow. See, drugs cause paranoia, don't they? If you rely on drugs for your state of mind, well, you need a source for those drugs, don't you? What if the source gets cut off? Then what do you do? So, relying on drugs, people get very desperate. They're very nervous, very paranoid, very manipulative. Well, some might say money's like a drug. But if we know how to practice with in our own mind, you know, there's no source other than ourselves of doing this. We can do this, so nobody can cut us off from this. Like, or blackmail us and say, you know, you got to pay me more money for this drug. Or, well, I got other people need it more than you, and what can you do for me? And start blackmailing you, that kind of stuff, and extorting you, based because your dependency on it. So if we depend on drugs for some sort of peace of mind, just consider just how enslaved we are because of that. You're asking for enslavement when you do that. So here, we can practice. It's free, and we can do it for ourselves. It doesn't cost anything. As soon as we start putting hope in things, then in our valuing of those things, we feel that, you know, our death is there because the thing could be taken away from us. We could be prohibited from having it. It could be stolen. It could be destroyed. It could be this. It could be that. The price could go way up. We couldn't afford it. Scarcity. We can't find it. But with this practice, how can there be scarcity? We can do it under any circumstances if we want to. The issue of scarcity can't really arise, can it? It's not some commodity we have to pay someone for. Okay, so the strain of this is probably enough. We've gone, how far have we gone? Like about an hour, a little bit over an hour. Tremendous, tremendous push here. Tremendous push. So let it settle in, and I'm going to bounce back from everything. And keep in mind, this is portable. We don't need a trailer hitch. We don't need to pull it behind us. It goes with us wherever we go. Wherever we go, we can use this practice. Sitting on a beach in Hawaii, let me say, oh, frame of reference shift, feeling more beautiful than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, feeling more lucid than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, feeling more tranquil than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, feeling more blessed than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, feeling more graced than expected. Wow. Frame of reference shift, obvious wow, feeling more graced than expected. Wow. Okay, great. Wow, the new way is wow. The new way is wow. The new way is wow.